What is going on, guys? Tidwolf here. Welcome back to some more Jurassic World. Last time we left off, we, you know, defeated the Ender Dragon, then casually went back to mining our building here at the Twin Emeralds Hotel, literally like nothing ever happened. Anyways, I got a few comments, actually probably like maybe a dozen or so, saying that yes, you do indeed get the Ender Lilies to grow a little bit faster if they're on the, which chest did I put these in? If they're on Endstone, that's Hive Block. Where are those? Is it still in my inventory? I don't see it there. Is it in my pocket or roo? Yep, I don't see it there either. I'm pretty sure I had Endstone somewhere. Oh, there it is. Alright, we have a little bit of Endstone right there. And some of the Ender Lilies, they look like they're already like, yeah, look at that, 14% on some of those. So I guess I might as well just dig some of them up. There we go, just dig them up, get my Ender Lilies back, and just put a little bit of Endstone here, and let those things grow. So, there we go. And you know what, let's... is this a square? Yeah, that is a square. Yep, that's a square. All right, let's just put down our juicy end stone, and we'll be able to grow ourselves a pretty good amount of Ender Lilies here in a bit. So, I don't know how much faster it makes them grow, but hopefully it makes them grow fast enough to where we can start getting enough Ender Pearls here in the future to start making those, like, 8 Tesseracts we're going to need for the jetpack. So there we go, and I guess we could put that one right there, and I suppose maybe here in the future, these Ender Lily seeds, once you break them, they do have a chance of dropping more seeds instead of just one. So yeah, anyways, I did get some comments about the second floor to this thing, and I'm just casually not even using the elevator, like it's nothing. I asked, hey, should I like have the carpet be the same color for the whole entire floor, or should like individual rooms have their own colored carpet, stuff like that? And actually I think a majority of you guys said that you wanted the whole entire floor to be like one colored carpet. So we're going to get ourselves a pretty good amount of carpet, as well as hide this little floor marker here. I also got started a little bit on this little edge here. This little edge that we worked on quite a while ago, and we do need to change that one out. And as you can see, I've been growing some more acacia wood over here, just so we can keep on working on that little edge right there. And I got started on the edge on the top one up there too, so you can see what it looked like with the windows. I didn't even do that window right. I thought it was a double window, but I guess not. Alright, let's go fix that real quick. Actually, for this elevator, what I want to do is have this, like, completely enclosed. So we might have to get rid of these windows right here. There we go. And, is there a window? Yep, the window fell out the back. Let's see, can we MLG parkour? Oh man, we could have done that. We could have totally done. Oh, let's try it here. Let's try it. And parkour, parkour legend. All right, let's see. This was not a double window, but was in fact a single window, right? I just need a million check this just to make sure it's all right. And I'm pretty sure all these other ones are nice and correct. Yep, there you go. And this back one's also a single window. Yep, single window and single window. All right. So let's go back home a little bit. And let's go retrieve our little elevator maintenance mode pass thing, whatever it's called. There is elevator tool, whatever. There we go. And we can go turn that thing into, actually, we have floor markers too, right? Yeah, we still have one more floor marker, so I'll take that. And we can set that floor marker for the third floor, which I can get started on here in a bit. And I do need some wool, so let's see, where is the wool? There's a little bit of wool right there. I don't think there's any more wool inside of here. We used a pretty good amount of it over there at the shops for those awnings, so we need to get more wool. We only have a little bit of string, so we may have to go shear some sheep. I'm not seeing any more wool anywhere. Well, let's see, do we have any of that lime dye? We do have cacti. Yep, we have some lime dye, so we can dye the current wool that we do have. And I guess just get some shears. Where in the world are my shears? There we go. Just get a little bit of shears, and you know what, let's put that there, since we're probably not going to use the power fist for a little while, since we're probably going to be building this entire episode. We're working on the Twin Emeralds Hotel a little bit more, and as I said earlier, once we get the second floor completely finished, I'll just do the third floor, fourth floor, etc. on my own. So let's see, we were going to place this floor marker somewhere, so I think it has to be one block above where the actual floor is going to be, kind of like that. So if the floor here is going to, falling all the way down. Let's see, let's go here. And the actual floor is going to go like here-ish. So there's that, there's the floor, and it needs to go here, right? So if I'm standing here, it'll be, no. It needs to go up one more block, right? It needs to go up like so, like that. So where I'm where I'm like eye level with it, right? Is that it right there? Yep. Where you're eye level with it, that's where it needs to go. And we do need to fill this bit in as well as this, because you're going to go up the elevator, and it wouldn't really make sense if you could just casually walk out of the elevator while you're going up it. So you need to have your passengers nice and safe and secured while they're riding the elevator up, just so they do not fall out and get, you know, injured, and you'll have like an insurance lawsuit on your hand. So let's just get ourselves some more jungle planks, place them down like so, and oh, there you go. Oh, oak wood. Do not want that oak wood. Whew. Let's get that jungle wood back in our inventory. Why does it keep giving me oak wood? There you go. And what are we going to do here? I suppose we can... Yeah, I don't know what we're going to do here, because we do have this acacia that's like halfway like that, and if we place the blocks here, it's going to get in the way of the elevator. Yeah, this is quite the predicament. Now, what are we going to do with this? We can't really... I guess we can do this, but it'd look weird, right? Whoops, didn't mean to break that. Let's break that. Yeah, that... I don't know. It does look weird. I guess maybe we can get the carpenter's blocks, make them like half slabs, vertical half slabs. We'll see what that'd look like if they're vertical half slabs. See how many more carpenter's blocks we have. Yeah, we have a pretty decent amount, right? Let's get that and the carpenter's hammer itself. There it is. And let's just go over there. Let's go see what it'd look like if they were like vertical half slabs. And then we just like use the carpenter's hammer to make them all half slabberoonies. So let's get these, break these blocks, and let's place down the carpenter's blocks and then fill them in with the jungle planks and then hit them with the hammer so they turn into like half blocks. So do that. Let's actually get this first row done. Let's see what it looked like. Because I don't know if we have enough carpenter. Actually, we might. Yeah, we should have enough to finish this. Yeah. Look at that. What do you know? All right, let's keep placing them. There you go. Let's fill those in now with the jungle plank. Oh, whoops. Did not mean to place that one there. Break it. Yep, we got it. And we just need to place those there and then use the hammer to punch that in. Now, there you go. I'm like, it's not bad. It is flush with the little arch there. So, maybe we can turn the arch to be not so flush and then to give it a little bit of depth. You know, just to kind of differentiate it from this elevator wall. But for right now, we need to fill this in a little bit just so we know what it looked like. Actually, so we do know what it looked like, because it'll actually be filled in. Let's see what it looks like now. If we do want those acacia blocks to be... Oh man, there you go. If we do want the acacia blocks to be full blocks, we can just right click them again with a hammer. Do that. And we might as well just retrieve our acacia back, right? In this case. Yeah, just to save a little bit of the carpenter's blocks, since they're going to be full blocks anyways. And yeah, this is what it looked like. I don't know. I don't know if I like that. I don't know. I guess maybe I can change these to be shift, break that, shift. Yeah, take these out. And we can put acacia here. Get those out. I don't know if I have an acacia in my inventory. I did harvest a little bit, I think. Yeah, we have a little bit. And we can put some acacia here. See what it looked like. Did not mean to do that. Let's place it like, to where it's vertical so we can see the bark on the outside. So it's a little bit like that. There we go. Yeah, I see this. Yeah, I like that one better. Yeah, let's do it like that. And get that one, and there we go, got it. Alright, yeah, this is a bit better, right? Yeah, I like it. If anything, maybe we can turn this bit here into a half slab, or not a half slab, but like a stair block. Kind of like what we have going on out here, where there's like a stair block right there. Let's go back to our house, let's see if we have any, I think we have some more cover stair blocks. So let's grab some of those. Yep, we have a really good amount of them right there. And let's go see what it looked like. We still need to finish that corner right there, put the stair blocks there, and of course get started on the second row right there, where we're having the second floor. So let's put down the stair blocks like so, and I guess we can just get rid of these here and place down actual acacia blocks, just so we save a little bit of carpenter's blocks, you know, just so we can use them later. All right, so there's that, and we can use regular acacia here. There we go. Place them down naturally. And fill this one in with regular acacia, like so. Yeah. Actually, this one needs to be horizontal, like so. There you go. Fill it in like so, all the way to here, right? Yeah, I think so. And there was a case right there. I don't know if I picked it up or not. Let's put the stair there, fill that in, and let's... Oh, man, I have exactly enough. Oh, look at that. Well, I guess I would, because we literally replaced that, but still. I think it looks good. I really do like it. That door's in the way. Oh, yeah, speaking of this door, we should probably have a door for the hole. Whoops, can you not go to the second floor? What? Chewie suffocated in the wall. Whoa! There are dinosaurs dying. No way. Who's suffocating in the wall? Oh, man. That's our first T-Rex that just died. Oh, and wasn't Chewie our first dinosaur? Or no, that was Chompy. Either way, it's still sad. Well, I want to find his dinosaur. Oh, there's his dinosaur. Is he? Oh, they're suffocating in the roller coaster here, right? Because this one's a little bit lower, but this one, because this goes up one more block. Oh, man, I'm going to have to fix that. I'm going to have to make this one go up one more block. And then, I guess right here where it goes down, I can make it come down a little bit. I guess we could do that now. Oh, man, rest in peace. I suppose we can use his... Oh, man, that's a lot of DNA. Oh, I suppose we can use his DNA to, you know, reincarnate himself. Just because, you know, it's his DNA. We're going to clone him. So we'll just act like nothing ever happened. So I suppose we can try and escape this area. Yeah, let's go out here. There's a random chicken out here. Yeah, I guess he's not named, so it's not that's not Colonel Sanders or Nugget or anything. So let's go over here and let's try to get on this roller coaster. God, I can't get on it. I have to go all the way over here if I want to get on that roller coaster. I still haven't had any progress over there just yet. Been a little bit too busy for that stuff. God, I can't go anywhere. Do I have any dirt? I have a little bit of dirt. Just place down like one dirt block there, right? Just to make it a little bit easier for us to go over here. I guess I could place down a dirt block over there as well. Well, let's go over here. We do have some jungle wood in our inventory. We need to get rid of all of these and then place them back down again, but one block higher. So let's get the jungle wood out. Let's get rid of all this and let's jump over here to the other side and break them like so, just so it's a little bit easier. And hopefully we don't accidentally hit a dinosaur while we're over here, so... Hopefully we don't, or else they'll like freak out and lag out the game. So, okay, there's a dinosaur like right under me right there. Hopefully we can just wait a little while and then, okay, I guess right here is where we can cut it off. Yeah, he's moving. Okay, there we go. He's moving. He's out of the way. Oh, now is our opportunity to get rid of these blocks without trying to accidentally murder him right here, or hit him at least. Because if we hit him, yeah, I just said he's going to lag out the game. Okay. He's literally right under us right now. I hope I don't... Oh, there we go. Okay, let's retrieve all of the blocks, all the rails. Okay, we don't have any inventory space for the rails. We have a lot of food. Oh, I'll put all that up. All right, let's get all the rails. Pick up all those rails. Let's replace them all up here. One block higher, just to make sure these guys do not suffocate. And yeah. This should be good right there. Did we get all the rails? I hope we did. Because if we're one short, then I'm going to have to come back down here and hopefully find the missing rail. So... Hopefully we have enough rails, and I guess I'll just place down one plank right there so I can jump up here. There we go. Right, and then we need to have this one keep going up, like so. Then we can just place it around like this. And where in the world is that? Okay, that meets up like over there. Is it? Okay, it's like right here. Okay, one more block, and we need to turn, go this way. And I'll break out the jungle blocks where we need to put the redstone block to power it. I decided to do the redstone block a little bit because it was a little bit easier. So right here is where the redstone block is. And I put these rails, like five rails, and then two powered blocks. So that's how it works. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then right here is where we're going to have the two powered rails. So I need to put down a redstone block right there just so it powers the rails. I know it was a little bit overkill, but it was a lot easier than trying to jump up and place the torches like over there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we need to get rid of this one, place down a redstone block. So, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And place down a redstone block here. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And place, oh, whoops, that was one early. Whoops, I'm gonna have to place down another jungle wood. Right there, place down another powered rail, and over here, I don't think we should be one block short. Yep, there you go, it connects perfectly. All right, so if anything, there's a little bit of jungle wood down here that we need to collect from the, oh, what's this, raw beef? Did they kill a cow? Why did they kill a cow right there? I guess I just casually killed a cow. Hashtag casually kill a cow. Alright, well, I guess it's going to work just fine if we try and ride it again or have any villagers riding it or anything like that. Because, oh man, our Tylosaurus is getting absolutely, all of them are getting really huge. Man, look at that. And they're getting so big that you can actually tell which ones are like different genders. Like, that one's a different gender than that one because it's a different color. And what about this one? Yeah, that one's getting pretty big too. He might not be getting as much attention as the other guys, but he's just over here chilling out in the water. In the very dark water. I still need to put like kelp and stuff over there. Man, I keep putting that off. Alright, well, let's keep on going over here. Let's go back to our Twin Emeralds Hotel that we were just working on. And I suppose we can put the, I think it's like the DNA analyzer, or DNA extractor. And you can put the T-Rex DNA inside there. And it's going to extract his DNA. So let's put that there. And hopefully it's going to extract, nope, it's extracting from the fossils, so let's put the fossils, I guess, in here. There we go, a little bit of sand. Man, I need to clean out my inventory so bad right now. Get rid of the oak wood, the jungle wood, we don't really need that right now. A little bit of oak wood as well. End stone, I don't need that anymore right now. And we still have all this wool that we were going to dye, so let's dye all this extra wool. There we go, and there we go. And let's dye it all lime, so there you go. And how many carpets do you get from this stuff? Oh, that's half slabs. 3 each? That's not bad. It's up to 12. Not bad at all. Alright, well, acacia saplings, we can get rid of that. Blue wool? I guess I can put that here. Put a lime dye in the middle until we get more wool and we can dye it in the future. But for right now, put up the sand. And let's check up on the extractor DNA. Yeah, look at that. We're clonium. There's going to be 3 Chewies compared to the one that we had before. So we have a little bit of cobblestone we got from that fossil earlier. And I can put that up. And we have some beef that we got from that dead cow. Alright, so we still have the wooden axe measuring tool. So there you go, we have 4 T-Rex Chewy DNA right there. If we want to clone him, maybe we can do that later. But for right now, we were over here just busy building, busy as a bee, buzz buzz. So let's see. We still have that maintenance tool. Yeah, we still have the maintenance tool. Let's go to the second floor, which is 77. Since I can't really just hippity hop, can't stop over here anymore. And we need to use the maintenance tool to turn this into, I need to go downstairs. Actually, I need to go down to the elevator computer or whatever. That's how I'm going to turn it into maintenance mode. So, yep, I just caught a glimpse of it right there. Turn that into maintenance mode. Oh, there you go, maintenance mode. And how am I going to get up there now? I don't know. Is this going to work in maintenance? Oh, okay, it's not going to work in maintenance mode. Is this still in maintenance mode? Oh, yeah, it is. As long as I'm holding the thing, I guess it's going to symbolize that it's in maintenance mode. Okay, let's see if we can do some MLG parkour out here to try and get to the second floor, because we can't take the elevator right now because it's in maintenance mode. Let's go here. There we go. And we need to right-click that block with what we want to disguise it as. So there's that. And we need to... How do I enable... Oh, whoa. Oh, barely caught my fall right there. How do we enable that one? I think just right-click it again, right? Let's see. Ah, there we go. Right-click. Maybe shift-right-click. I don't know. There we go. Blocks successfully bound to the elevator. Okay, so now we can hide that one like that. And I guess we're out of the maintenance mode. So let's go back. There we go. Maintenance mode is complete. So now we should be able to go up to 82, which is going to take us up to what is going to be the third floor. And let's just see if we placed it in the right spot. All right, look at that, we did. So this is going to be the floor. Now let's go to the second floor, 77. I had some ideas for this hallway right here. So whenever I placed these blocks down, they were all flat and stuff, you know? So I thought, what if we got some stairs, like jungle wood stairs? I should have, I still have this workbench in here. What if we put some jungle wood stairs here and, you know, maybe give it a little bit more personality and stuff, you know, just so it's not all flat. And let's see what that looked like. So let's get rid of a few of these stairs here. And the great thing about using these stairs is that on the bottom, they're going to be a different shape, but on the top, they're still going to be flat. So how are we going to not like that the exact other way around is what I want to do. So let's I still have that dirt. No, I think I do. Wow, I still have that dirt. All right, let's place it down like so. Place down the dirt, and let's go down here and place the stairs. Oh, whoops, stairs like this. And then we can put planks or half slabs on the very ceiling of it too. So that would give it a little bit of personality, you know. And as I said earlier, at the top you can you can't tell the difference between, you know, just the regular floor and the bottom of the stair. Or, I guess, in this case, the top of the stair. Let's place it back down. And, I really do like that already. Let's get ourselves some slabs from the jungle wood. There we go. And let's see what it looked like once we replace this middle bit here with some half slabs. You know, I've never really done building this in depth before, you know? I've always just had some really simple stuff and just called it a day. But now I'm actually getting really into this building stuff, especially because we do have the, you know, carpenter's blocks and the forge micro block stuff. And, you know what? I really do like that. Yeah, I do like that. Over here, of course, it's still just regular blocks. This, of course, as well. And, do I like having it as this, a full block? Or do I like having this as like a stair block? Let's change half the hallway to be regular, and then half of it can be stairs, just so we can differentiate which one's better. And maybe I can ask you guys what you guys think. So let's have this as regular. So that's what it looked, actually, we need to turn that into regular like that. So that's what it looked like. Do you guys, actually I need to make another set of stairs before I properly show it off, so let's get a few more stairs made. There we go. And let's go up here. Let's break this row over here and place down a little bit of dirt just so we can place them down again. And, all the way out to here and place the dirt like so. Then we can see what it looked like once we have stairs up here compared to, you know, regular full blocks. So here we go. What do you guys think? Do you guys like where it's like this, where it's like regular blocks and then half slabs in the middle? Or do you like this, where it's like, you know, stairs and then half slab in the middle? I personally like the stairs, because it's a little bit out of the way. Like, you can really tell that there's something going on here, but whenever you're here, it's just like, oh yeah, it's just a ceiling. It's just a normal ceiling, you know? Like, this one's a little bit more chilled out, and this one's more in your face. So let me know what you guys think. Do you guys like this one over here with the full blocks or with the stairs? I really want to know what you guys think. But for right now, you know what? I'm going to turn the rest of it into stairs, just because that's personally what I like. And, you know, maybe if you guys see the whole thing as stairs, maybe that'll change your mind. I guess we can get rid of the rest of this dirt that we're not going to be using, because we've already placed down the stair blocks there. And we need to go get ourselves a couple more crafts of the stairs. And let's get a few of those going, like so. All right, let's see what it looks like when the whole entire hallway is stairs. And then we can start working on, didn't we have more? What happened to stairs? I thought we made more stairs than that, right? I thought we did. Well, whatever, there you go, 44 stairs, right there. All right, let's place down the dirt here. Then we can place down the stairs here at the very end and on the sides, just to see what it looked like, because I think it looks fantastic with the stairs. All right, let's place them down, see what it looks like. It's already taking shape, and it looks fantastic already. And look at that. Look at that. Yeah, see? It's really not in your face. It's really just kind of chill. And we do have some glass. So we can put some glass here at the end of the hallway, like so. And yeah, we do need to put torches here as well, because it is getting pretty dark, and just to light it up a little bit. And I suppose we can make some paintings and stuff here in the future. Start decorating the inside of the actual, rooms here, you know, putting down beds, maybe have one of them have like one giant bed, and then another one might have two regular beds, and then maybe another one would have one giant bed and one small bed, like, you know, maybe one for parents and with a little kid, who knows? And you know, that'd be so dank as a kid having your own bed. I don't know about you guys, but I always had to share one with one of my parents when I was a kid, when I was at a hotel and stuff. Ah, man. These kids are living large these days, getting their own bed at the Twin Emerald Hotel. Anyways, we do have a little bit of carpet here, so let's just start the carpet here from the actually. You know, it's kind of weird having the elevator like straight up here, you know? I feel like maybe, do we have any extra? Oh, we don't have a little bit of acacia. Let's go out here. Let's cut down one of these trees that was growing during the episode, or before the episode. I think all these grew right before the episode started. Let's go back upstairs using the actual elevator itself. Man, this looks so weird whenever there's nothing there. Yeah, I should probably put something there. Yeah, it's kind of weird whenever the elevator's like at the third floor and there's nothing down here. All right, let's go. I'm glitching. Oh, go to the second floor. Oh, man, I thought I was glitched forever there. Jeez. All right, so we have a little bit of acacia. And what I thought was, that's totally not what I wanted to do. place down a little bit of acacia like so. And yeah, I should probably get a little bit more, but this is the general idea of what I wanted to do. Have a little bit of a doorway there for the elevator, you know? And maybe even use carpenter's blocks for this, just so it's not so, you know, gigantic. You know, let's do that. Yeah, let's do that. Let's fill this in with carpenter's blocks, with acacia, and make it go, because since we're going to have a door here, and the door's going to be like, I don't know, a fourth of the size of the actual entranceway, it wouldn't really make that much sense to have entire full blocks here. They kind of get in the way, so let's do that, turn this one to the side one. Whoops, that is not, whew, I don't want that one to be like that, and there's that. Let's get rid of that, and is this going to work? There we go. And let's make these like so. All right. So that's what it looked like. Let's get our crafting table down. And let's remake, or let's actually make a, ooh, this is where having those oak planks would have come in handy. But I don't have any right now. Is this oak? Is that oak? Nope, that's jungle. That's jungle as well. Where's all the oak at? I guess I mine it all. But let's see, is it? I'm pretty sure there's oak here, right? That's jungle too. That's jungle. There's jungle there too. Man. Well, I guess I'll go over here. See if we can find an oak tree. Up there, yeah, a little bit of oak. Just enough to get ourselves a... Oh, did I even get the... Oh, yeah, I picked up the oak. I didn't even see it fly into my inventory right there. Just enough to make ourselves an oak door. Since I like the look of the oak door. If you ask me, personally, I think the dark oak looks the best. Like, if I can get my hands on some dark oak, then I would probably change every door in the Twin Emeralds Hotel to be dark oak, because it's like a really, it's a really dark brown that doesn't have any windows. Oh, not the third floor, it's the second floor. Is this going to take me to the second floor? Nope, it's going to take me to the third floor. Whoops. Oh, whoa, why did... Oh, there you go. I didn't even do anything right there. All right, let's make ourselves a regular old oak door just for this little entrance way, and we can put it right here. There you go, like that. And we need to get the hammer out. Dilophosaurus DNA. What do I have to... Oh yeah, that's from the DNA extractor. Already had a little bit of Dilophosaurus DNA inside of it. We already have the hammer here. Let's punch that in like so. And let's get that crafting table out of the way, since we don't really need it right now. And there we go. Alright, so... Oh man, I probably should have got some acacia while I was still down there. Let's send this thing down to the lobby just so it's already down there by the time we're done cutting down an acacia tree. And let's just finish that little elevator entranceway just to see what it looked like. Once, yeah, kind of like this. I want it to look like that, you know? But then in the future, if we can get our hands on some juicy dark oak, we're going to be replacing all of these with dark oak doors. So here we go. There you go. Look at that. You arrived at the second floor, and there's a door for you to go through. It'd be a lot cooler if we had like doors that opened up from the sides, like actual elevators. But unfortunately, we don't have those yet. So let's place these down like so, and let's get that acacia we just got, fill that in like that, and I suppose here on the other side, we can just fill it in with regular old jungle wood that we've been using for everything else. So let's do that. Actually, what does that look like? Yeah. Okay, so we should probably get the stairs to do a little bit of this, kind of like what we did over there at the other end, so... There's a little bit of jungle there, and where is this at? Yeah. Do we have the stairs in our inventory? Do we have enough? We need three, I think. Did we break them? I thought we broke some stairs, right? Oh, yeah. We just stacked with our gigantic stack of stairs we already had. All right, that's not the way I want it to go. There we go. Oh, whoops. Upside, I have to place it on the very top block. There we go. And there we go. Alright, so that's what I wanted it to look like. And then we can place this down like so. I don't know if I like that. And maybe we can push this one back to like there, you know? And then push this wall to be half slabs, like vertical half slabs, with the carpenter's blocks. So it kind of, I don't know if I want it to be flush with this though. Let's just test that out. Let's see what it'd look like. So let's get our dirt. Let's place it down like this. And let's place down the upside down half slabs like that. Or the upside down stair blocks. And then if we get regular jungle wood. If we get the regular jungle wood, it'd look like that. Or maybe stairs. Let's see what it looked like with regular jungle wood stairs. That way it kind of transitions into it. I like that. That isn't that bad. Yeah, that actually looks pretty good. What do you know? Alright, so there you go. So, let's actually go down to the lobby. Let's see what it looked like if you're a new guest at the Twin Emeralds Hotel, and you go to your room that is on the second floor. So, you know, you arrive at the Twin Emeralds Hotel, you open up the front door, go to the front desk. That isn't even finished yet. We still need to work on this desk. Maybe do some cool Forge microblock stuff with it, you know? But you get your key, you go over here, you go to the second floor, Y-axis 77, and you're like, hey, here it is right here, here's the door. What do you know? I wish that was Dark Oak. And you're like, wow, this place looks fantastic. And we need to place down that carpet here as well. I guess we can get started on the hallways, and then, what are we going to do here? Can we put, if we put something there, are we going to see the... I don't know what we're going to do with this bit here. If I put jungle wood there, it's going to look weird because we can't cover it up with carpets. The carpet's just going to start like right here. So if this is all green carpet like that, you know, it just looks weird like that. And we can't just turn these into green wool or else it'd look weird from the bottom. Yeah, I don't know what to do with that, but this is what it's going to look like. The first floor, of course, is going to be green, you know, because Green Emeralds Hotel. And maybe the next one can be, like, blue or maybe yellow, and we can kind of follow a little bit of a rainbow pattern to where it, like, kind of transitions to each color flawlessly. So, I think that's going to be me for right now. So, anyways, thank you guys all very much for watching. If you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to let me know by leaving a like down below. Hopefully it wasn't too much of a building episode for some of you guys. I know some of you guys like the building episodes, some of you guys don't. But hopefully you guys enjoyed either way. So thank you guys all very much for watching. And I'll see you guys here next time with some more Jurassic World. Oh, bye there.